dear children, we will start with a new lesson, that is population of geography. Okay, what population is? There is one activity in your textbook, that is how many students are there in your class, out of the total number, how many are boys and how many are girls, how many are absent and what is the total strength of the class. All these things are asked. Last year's you can refer, because this year you did not attend your class, isn't it? Or either you did not sit together with your friends. So either other than that, we can take the example of our sitting, we can take the example of your building, the people who live in your building, or how many of them are there in one house. All this calculation, okay, so that we call it as population. So population means the number of people or the number of this living organism. Other living organisms also we call them as population. Population of dogs, population of cats, or other living organism. Okay. But here we are going to study in geography the population of human beings. Okay. So in that area, the number of people living in a particular area or living in a region, that we call it as population. Okay. So in your class, what is the population? Suppose your area of your class is 200 square centimeter. That means 20 meters by 20 meters. So it will become 200 square meters. Okay, so that is your area of the class. And in that class, suppose 60 students are there. So we will say that the population of the class, that is 60 per how much area, that is in that area. If suppose population increased, if suppose you include more number of students, then the population will go on increasing. It will become more dense. Okay, so population density will go on increasing, or either it will go on decreasing. So that is called as the population of that area. So there are several factors which are responsible for the growth and development of the population. So growth and development of the population, how you can growth of the population by birth, or growth can come down by death rate. Okay, but development of the population can be developed. They can become good people, they can become good citizen, they can become good educated people. So this development is because of either the migration of educated people from one city, from one region to another region, or either the people who are occupied in their business and earning amount for developing that region. Okay, so you will find some of the regions are rich and some of the region are lower level. That means there are very small shops. Studying the population of any region, the following aspects have to be studied, have to be known. So what are those following aspects? These are population growth, population distribution, population density, and the structure of the population. Okay, so during all this population growth, how the growth of the population, the density of the population, whether the people are more in number or they are less in number, that is density. So we will further study about the population of that region. Okay, so that our lesson, that is of geography, which lesson we are studying, lesson number 7, that is population. Okay, so the population growth, there are factors, the increase or decrease in the population relates with some factors. So population growth, it can grow, population can grow with the help of birth rate. Birth rate means the number of live birth. Some birth of the child are, the child is dead after the birth, but here live birth of the of the person. So it is the number of live birth per 1000 people in a year. It shows you the birth rate. Birth rate, the amount of birth per 1000 people. Okay, so that is called as birth rate. Death rate. So the number of deaths per 1000 people in a year. It shows the death rate. Okay, the number of death per 1000 people, we call that number as death rate. How many people die in that 1000 group of people, we call that rate, that number as death rate. Flags of different countries. Okay, so how much span, lifespan the people live, average lifespan the people live in that country. Okay, so you could find England and all this China Republic. So all these are Australia, Singapore, Hong Kong, and your United States, United Kingdom, Germany. From your right hand side will go, that is United States. People live, average life of people is 79 age. Up to 79 age most of the people live their life in United Kingdom. From right hand side you come, the average lifespan of people is 81. In Germany, average lifespan of people 81. So all these things you just refer, that is Republic of Korea, that is 82, Singapore 83, Hong Kong 84, Japan that is 84, okay, Australia. Could find out about India, the average lifespan of the people of India. Okay, so this is the life expectancy. So according to this life expectancy, what happens, our population is also been either increased or decreased. If people die at early age, then what will happen, population will decrease. Okay, so whether the population is suffering from disease condition, okay, or whether the population is suffering from diabetes or many other reasons are there. Okay, some of those people become old, even though some of the old people are very energetic, that means they are occupied in work. Okay, so that is called as life expectancy, the average lifespan of an individual expected in an area at the time of birth. Okay, whenever the person is being born or whenever the child is born, it is expected to live at least 80 years or 90 years. Okay, so that is the life expectancy. So that has included in that population, the child is being now included in the number of people or the population. So here you could see India's birth and death rate. You will find in 1901, from 1901 to 2001, you could find the birth rate and the death rate and the growth rate. Okay, how much growth in population it is. Got that? Yes. So you just study the population growth and these four parts, some of their population increases or either decreases according to, one more part is there, that is the migration means